Okay, so on to chapter 12, Runaway Clown. Okay, so they start us off here in the pumpkin, or the big pumpkin head apparently. And there's this golden pumpkin on this stump. And it's kind of a pain in the ass to get to, because you gotta like triple jump up to there. There we go, okay. And I think I talked about that in the last video, like, how, isn't there supposed to be a pumpkin up here or something? So, yeah, there it is. Okay, so, now we're gonna have to run all the way back to town, and it kinda takes a couple minutes because it's so far away, so I'm actually just gonna edit, I'm just gonna, you know, cut back into when I'm in town, so I will be back in just a second. Okay, so here I am back in the town. I'm just gonna drink this water, fill up my bottle, and heal up really quick. Okay, so now we have to go to the residential area, which is back here. Okay, it says the gate is locked. So let's open up the menu. And whoops, use the key, which it's not letting me use it for some reason. Maybe because I'm like in the middle of an attack or something? Like, what the hell? Okay, there we go. Alright, now the gate's open. Okay, so here is the residential area. And let's talk to this witch, why not?
I was on my way home to get some more supplies when I heard someone screaming and saw clown riding around. It seems those Oogie baddies installed some kind of engine in Clown's unicycle. Jack, I wonder if you might have something in your bag of tricks that could slow him down.
My bag of tricks, huh? Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Okay, so let's lay down a bunch of presents. Wait for him to roll past him. Oh, here he comes. Stun him, try to talk to him maybe? No, nothing happened. Okay then.
I guess the only way to stop Clown is to remove that engine, and not even my spells can do that. If you had some kind of tool, you might be able to take it out while he's stopped. I wonder where one could find such a tool.
I wonder, maybe Dr. Finkelstein, maybe? It's worth a try. Wait, this isn't the way to Dr. Finkelstein's? Was it back this way? No, it's not in there. I think this is it. This must be the place. Okay then. This is a kind of a long walk, isn't it? Now I'm gonna have to go all the way back up this spiral ramp here. Okay, so here's Sally's room, which it was blocked off when we first came here, but now it's open, so let's just head on in, shall we? And inside we have a crystal skull. So you collect 4 to make a bottle. We currently have 3, so we just need one more. And actually, I think there's one that we can get in the graveyard right now, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm gonna have to look that up after this video, and if there is one, then I'll collect it in the next chapter. And you can see here, there's all of these skeletons here. This is actually a pretty good place to grind, I found. Which I actually did do a bunch of grinding here off the clock. So in the beginning of the next chapter, I'm gonna have like a crazy amount of money. Like I think like 20,000 or something. Wait a minute. We gotta go up this way. No? Oh wait, it was past. I don't know, whatever. I hate this place. Alright, let's talk to the doctor here.
Oh, is that you, Jack? Well, you say you need a tool. Help yourself there over there. Say, Igor's been babbling about something. Would you mind listening to what he has to say?
Alright, so the tool we need to stop Clown is right here. So you just go up to it, press X, and you get the bone driver. Alright then, what was the doctor saying about Igor needing something?
Jack, listen to Igor. Igor was eating bone biscuit when I hear manhole scratch. I turn, no scratch. I turn back. Biscuit gone! Oh, Jack, get Biscuit back, please! Then Igor help you.
Okay, so now this is actually a secret chapter. Bone Biscuit Burglary. And, it's one of 2 secret chapters in the game. And I think the other secret chapter I actually could have done already. I think it was in chapter 7, actually. But I don't know. I obviously missed it if it was in chapter 7. I mean, I can always go back and replay chapter 7 to try and find it. And of course, they're gonna make us walk all the way back down. Dude, I hate this place. That didn't work out as planned. For some reason I thought, hey, why don't I just jump over that gap? But nope. Alright, so for the secret chapter, we're gonna have to head back around the house here. Into this manhole. Which actually, you couldn't get into before. If you try to go in it, Jack is just like, there's no reason to go down there. And down here we got the boss fight against the spider, and it works pretty much the same as the other time we fought him, which was in some other chapter. I don't know which one, was it 7 or 6? You just hit that part on the back of him, and he splits up into a bunch of little spiders, and then attacking the little spiders actually does the damage to him. Although it's kind of a little bit harder because you don't have the music notes, which always does a whole bunch of extra damage to bosses. I'm not sure if he's actually like stronger or like if he has more health or nothing. I don't know. Okay, where are you? There you are. Okay, then. Actually, let's put on another blue soul. Because why not? I mean, look at all this damage it does. I just attacked a whole bunch of them. Okay, so I got him down to about half health. And I'm in pretty good shape. I don't think he's touched me once. Or maybe he has, I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention. Alright, just use another blue soul. Oh, come on. Dude, quit it. Okay, so he's becoming, like, faster and more agile, so it's kind of getting a bit harder to actually hit him. Alright, he's almost dead. Maybe like one or two more like cycles or whatever those are. Alright, let's use a blue soul just to try to beat him on this time, like, without having to go through a whole nother wave. Oh, he's almost dead. No, get him, he's like the last spider. There we go. Okay. Is that it? Is he dead? And there he goes. Alright, we get the bone biscuits. Did all that money disappear before I can even get to it? That was bullshit. Dude, the money disappears way too fast. Like, you can't even finish up a combo by the time it disappears. Anyway, we're gonna have to go all the way back up to Igor. And I'm probably just gonna edit this out. Okay, I got your biscuits for you.
Soul bonus!
Alright, secret chapter complete. We get 2,000. 2,000 monies, that's our big reward. Alright, so now let's actually go back to Clown and save him, because that's the whole point of this chapter. Which is chapter 12, that was just a bonus chapter. So back to the residential area I go. Okay, so I'm back here in the residential area.
Soul robber.
No brakes.
Alright, switch to Sandy Claus. Throw out the presents. Wait for him to run by them. Come on. Whoops. Wow, I totally hit the wrong button there. That's okay. Oh wait, no it's not. That was bullshit. Alright, there you go. Now we gotta run up to him. Go into the menu and use the item. This is so stupid how you have to go into the menu like this to use items, but whatever. It's just some bad game design, I think.
Oh, at last! I finally stopped! Oh, my eyes are spinning!
Are you alright, clown?
Yes, thanks to you! I hope those vampire brothers up the street are okay. I saw some of Oogie's monsters headed that way when my cycle went psycho.
I hope so too. But that gate is closed and I can't get through.
No problem. There's a secret lever on the top of my house. I'll open the gate for you, and the mayor's house is on the other side.
Okay, chapter complete.
Clear time.
And I did horrible on time, but that's because I did the secret chapter.
Exclamation marks count. Nightmare rank.
Oh no, see, like I give any sort of fuck.
Soul bonus,
it doesn't matter cause in the start of the next chapter I'm gonna have like over 20,000 monies. So I'm gonna make sure to pay a visit to the shop and buy some upgrades. So anyway, on to the next chapter it is.